The southwest was warned to batten down the hatches, with residents in some parts told to evacuate as floodwaters hit. Camden was a different sight today, though, as those waters receded, revealing the destruction beneath and, of course, the clean-up ahead.
A club is at the centre of a community, and it's the community that's helping to get the ball rolling here again. The water has disappeared almost as fast as it came, swallowing up the Camden Sports Club, which was looking more like a swimming centre with chairs and tables just about floating.
You sort of thought, you know, if it ever happens, we'll be able to get in and get the equipment out, but it just happened so quickly overnight, we didn't get the opportunity.
Everything here is soaked, leaving the club to strip back to the basics and without insurance to help cover the losses.
We've lost, probably lost our income for the next six to eight weeks, I suppose.
Dozens helped to get what they could upstairs. Now they're back doing more of what they can to assist.
When it went down late yesterday afternoon, we put the call out for a few volunteers, and about 30 or 40 people were here in no time.
We've just got to bear with everything now at the moment and just take day by day and see what happens.
The caravan park, where 100 people were told to leave, has undergone another overnight transformation as waters dropped.
I think I might have dodged the bullet, but we'll see what happens when I go inside.
It's hard to believe that this truck was almost entirely underwater yesterday, and now with the floodwaters having finally receded, it's about to be towed away.
The braking system locked up and wouldn't let me go. So once I stopped, the waters got to the computer, I think, and that was it. I couldn't move it, and then I watched the water slowly rise yesterday till it went over the top.
The floodwaters weren't just high, but also powerful.
So it's quite remarkable that the waters managed to pick it up and move it all that way.
Emily's equestrian centre's been inundated twice in 5 days. The horses are safe, and she got the cats out too. Now there's the clean-up, which is only beginning.
Trying to retrieve what equipment. We've lost a lot of equipment. All our show jumps have gone and across-country jumps.
Alice Hogg for 10 News First.